Tonight, new questions emerging about lavish spending and potential conflicts of interest at the National Rifle Association. The Washington Post reports that the NRA has been paying hundreds of thousands of dollars to board members who are supposed to be unpaid and who have oversight over the gun rights group's finances. CNN's Tom Foreman has been looking into all of this for us. Tom, this is the latest in a series of controversies involving the NRA.
Yeah, and these revelations about how the NRA is spending its money and who is benefiting could test the loyalty of some NRA members like nothing we've ever seen before.
$3 million to a firearms company executive, $400,000 to a former pro football player, $255,000 to a former police officer, and $50,000 to a rock star. In all, the Washington Post cites 18 members of the National Rifle Association board getting paid for a variety of goods and services by the NRA. Illegal? No. But for a powerful tax-exempt organization, such matters can draw scrutiny from the Internal Revenue Service. George Danini is an attorney focused on corporate law.
It calls into question, at least potentially, people acting in their own self-interest versus the interests of the organization to which they owe a fiduciary duty.
Tax law says a 501c3 organization, such as the NRA, is prohibited from allowing its income or assets to benefit insiders, typically board members, officers, directors, and important employees. The NRA says the Post has presented a distorted view, and in the close-knit community of gun rights supporters and the NRA, connections between employees or board members and strategic partners are not unusual. But other allegations are also rocking the gun rights group.
I always feel at home at an NRA annual meeting, surrounded by law-abiding citizens of this great republic.
NRA President Oliver North was pushed out when he went to war with longtime CEO Wayne LaPierre, who has been accused of lavish spending on clothes, foreign travel, and approving exorbitant legal fees.
Well, I'll tell you, the only reason I can keep up this fight is because of you.
LaPierre pointed the finger at North, accusing him of cashing in on an NRA deal with an advertising company. Everyone is denying everything, but amid this, the New York Attorney General has launched a probe. Congressional investigators are looking at alleged contact between NRA officials and some people caught up in the Russia investigation. And even President Trump, who loves the NRA,
"You are great American patriots,"
has tweeted, "Stop the internal fighting and get back to greatness."
To be sure, for the NRA to lose its tax-exempt status would be a stretch, but if that happened, Wolf, it truly could threaten the very ability of the organization to exist.
Tom Foreman reporting for us. Thank you very much.